My name is Temitope Ajibola, also known as T-Square. I'm here to take a topic in physics, momentum, and Newton's law. Momentum and Newton's law. Now, in Newton's law, we all know that Isaac Newton put forward laws in physics, and the law is under law, Newton's law, and that is the law we are still using up to today. Although someone stated and derived the equation before, that was Leonhard Euler, but it is not valid. But Isaac Newton also came up with his own valid equation and laws. What are the Newton's law? The Newton's law, the function of the Newton's law is what? To govern motion of objects, either under gravity or in a straight line. That is Newton's law of motion. And there are three laws. So as a Newton put forward, the first one is what? It is, and that one states that a body continues in its present state of rest, or if it is in motion, it will move in a straight line unless it is compelled by an external force. Again, the first law is what? A body continues in its present state of rest, or if it is in motion, it will move in a straight line unless it is compelled by an external force. Take for example, this is a platform. We place an object there. This object can stay like this till eternity. So it is in its present state of rest. Then, take for instance, something like this now, a sloping, narrow the ball. So the ball will be rolling till eternity. So this body is in the present state of rest. Why this one is in uniform motion? It will roll till eternity. Why this one will stay till what? Eternity. That's why I say a body will continue in its present state of rest, or if it is in motion, it will move in a straight line unless it is compelled. What can stop this object from moving is what? External force, reaction forces, e.g. air. As this object is moving down, it is opposed by air. That is why we say unless it is compelled by an external force. And that Newton's first law is also called law of inertia. Law of inertia. Look at it. Law of inertia. What is law of inertia? Law of inertia is it is the tendency of a body to remain at rest or to move with constant motion. The tendency of a body to remain at rest or to move in what? Constant motion. That is what we call law of inertia. It is under Newton's first law. It is under Newton's first law. That is the first law. And then the second law says that the rate of change of momentum of a body, the rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to the applied force and take part in the direction in which the force acts. Again, the rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to the applied force and take part in the direction in which the force acts. Now, look at this, is an object. You are pushing this object, you are applying a force on this object to change from its initial position to a final position. So to move, there is a change in momentum there. Change in momentum. Now, and the change in momentum is proportional to the wall, the force applied to it. That I say, the rate of change of momentum of the body moving from here to this place, which means there is a change in momentum, is directly proportional to the wall, apply force, and move or take part in the direction in which the wall force acts. Now, in this case, we measure the word momentum. What is a momentum? Momentum is the product of force and velocity of a body. Mass and velocity of a body. Again, momentum is what? It is product of mass and velocity of a body. This is what we call momentum. In this case, this body has initial. Why this is what? Final. So this is U. Why this is what? V. Change the momentum. What does it mean? Which means you subtract the lower one from the higher one, which means mv minus mu. Mv minus mu. This is what we call change in momentum. It's directly proportional to the wall. Apply force. Apply force. Now talk about the rates. Because in the statement said the rate of change of momentum of the body is directly proportional to the wall applied force. When you cross multiply, you have one now, Ft equals wall, K into wall, Mv minus wall. So far we have air resistance, the K is equal to wall, 1. So we have one, Ft is equal to wall, Mv minus Mu. So this is under second law of Newton's second law. This derivation is under. And when you look at the one here, Ft, it is called impulse. Mv, it is called what? Change in momentum. Which means mathematically, I'm telling you or putting it to you that in physics, when you calculate, your impulse must be the same as change in momentum. That is what you have to know. They may ask for calculate change in momentum, they will not give you mass and velocity. They will give you force and time, and they will ask you to calculate change in momentum. Just multiply the force and time together. It's as well as same as well now. Change in wall momentum, don't forget. Now, the third law. That one says that to every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. To every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. Which means action and reaction are equal but opposite. Which means we have a table like this, we have a mass on the table. It's putting an action. Let's say the action is what? Is R. Then reaction, let's say it is what? N. Action and reaction are equal, which means M must equal to R. Our Newton's third law says action and reaction are equal but opposite. So the action the object is putting on the table must also equal to the reaction the table is applying back on the object. That is Newton's third law. Action and reaction are equal but opposite. Then where do we apply the third law? Number one, we have recoil of a gun. Recoil of a gun. That is where we apply the Newton's third law. When you shoot a gun, fire the bullet from a gun, the bullet moves in opposite direction to the movement of the gun. So which means the gun jerks backward as the movement the bullet moves forward. Now say the momentum of the gun must equal to the what? Momentum of the bullet, which means for gun, that mg vg must equal to what? Mb vb, which means this mb is what? Mass of the gun. Vg is what? Velocity of the gun. Mb is what? Mass of the bullet. Vb is what? Velocity of the bullet. So that is the first aspect of the third law. The second one is what? Rockets. Repulsion. Jet and rocket repulsion. In jet and rocket repulsion, they also apply the third law in the combustion engine. So that the force or thrust must equal to what? Mv over T. So this T represents the thrust, which is what? Mv over what? T. So this F is what? The thrust. M is what? Mass. V is what? Velocity. T is what? Time. So this is the second one we have to know under what? Jet and rocket repulsion. Then what's for habit in what? Lift and elevator. Lift and elevator. When the lift is moving up or down, or elevator is moving up or down, we have to study the motion of the lift or elevator. That is the third aspect you have to know. Lift and elevator. Now the first aspect is what? When the lift is moving down, moving down. So which means the reaction of the floor is more than the wave. That is why. So we have R minus mg equals what? Ma. So R equals what? Mg plus ma. So this R represents the tension. The tension of the lift, or the tension, the total reaction of the lift. So this is the acceleration due to gravity. What is what is ordinary acceleration? This is downward motion. Then number two, we have upward motion. When it is moving upward, the reaction of the floor of the lift is greater than the weight of the lift. So we have a mg. The weight of the lift is greater than the reaction. We have something like this now. When you make this one, the solid formula R equal to what? Mg minus ma. This is upward motion. Don't forget, when it is moving upward, the weight of the lift is greater than the what? The reaction. That is why it's moving upward. And this is the equation to calculate the total reaction on the what? Lift. Then, when it is what? When it is moving up or down with constant speed, which means acceleration is equal to what? Zero. When it is moving up or down with constant speed. It does not accelerate again. So which means R equals what? Mg. So when the lift is moving up or down with constant speed, which means acceleration becomes zero. From this equation, we have this equation. That is the formula to calculate the total force on the lift. Then, when it is falling freely, so which means acceleration is equal to what? G. R is equal to what? Zero. When the lift or elevator is falling freely, which means acceleration is equal to what? Acceleration due to gravity. Therefore, no reaction. So it will experience weightlessness. So the reaction or the total force must equal to what? Zero. That is the lift and elevator. Let's go to what? Collision. What is collision there? Collision. It is when two or more particles meet or encounter it one another. So we have under this aspect, collision could be elastic or inelastic. Under the aspect, the collision could be what? Elastic or inelastic. When it is elastic collision is what? When both energy and momentum are conserved, both before and after, that is elastic collision. Again, both energy and momentum will be conserved during collision, that is elastic. But inelastic is that the energy is conserved but the momentum is not conserved. That is inelastic collision. Now, under the collision, we have three cases. Case one, it is when two bodies collide. But this is before collision, why this is what? After collision. So when they are moving, if the two bodies move in the same direction, m1, u1, that is the velocity of this one, then the mass of this one, m2, u2. After collision, the two bodies move together, m1, m2. This is the common velocity. Now, the momentum of this one is what? m1, u1. Plus, why is it plus? Because they are moving in the same direction. The momentum of the second body, m2, u2. This is before collision. Then after collision, we have v is equal to what? m1 plus m2. Now, in this case, let us make the v the same formula. V is equal to what? m1 u1 plus m2 u2 over m1 plus m2. This is to calculate common velocities when two bodies are moving in the same direction. Then to calculate the case two is when the two bodies are moving in opposite direction. You just change this formula. V is equal to what? M1 U1 minus M2 U2. It will not disturb this. M1 plus M2, it will remain the same like this. Now this one is to calculate, it is case 2. Case 2 is when they are moving opposite direction. and this is the formula to calculate the wall common velocity. Then case 3. When one object is moving and the other object is stationary, e.g. shooting an arrow on a wooden block resting on the table. Shooting an arrow on a wooden block resting on the table. That is a typical example of case 3. So the common velocity will be given as well now. M1 U1 over M1 plus M2. That is our case 3 here. Case 3. So that is when one object is moving and the other object is not moving. So this is to calculate the common velocity for the case 3. Now these are the cases we have under collision. Then we also have what we call restitutional coefficients. Restitutional coefficients. What is restitutional coefficient? The restitutional coefficient is denoted by E. Is what? Change in initial velocities over change in final velocities. Again, change in initial velocities over change in final velocities. So, now, what is the meaning of the value of restitutional coefficient now? Restitutional coefficient is what? Change in initial velocities over change in what? Final velocity. And is that you have a U1 minus U2 over V2 minus V1. What this E represents the what? Restitutional coefficient. Restitutional coefficient. For perfectly elastic, E must equal to what? 1. For perfectly elastic collision, that is E must equal to 1. Then E must less than 1 for perfectly inelastic. Then E must equal to 0 for inelastic. So these are the values of what? Restitutional coefficients for Newton's law of motion and collision of objects. So that is the aspect. So afterwards, let's go towards some example involving Newton's law of motion. Now, take for instance, question number 1. An object of mass 30 kg moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second collides with another body of mass 10 kg moving with a velocity of 20 meter per second. Calculate the common velocity after the impact. Look at now, this question is under case 1, because when you look at the question very well, they've told you the direction. They said a body of mass 30 kg moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second collides with another body moving, another body of mass 10 kg moving with velocity of 20 meter per second in the same direction of the air. So calculate the common velocity. So far you have in the same direction. The formula is V is equal to what? M1 U1 plus M2 U2 over M1 plus M2. So V is equal to what? What is M1? M1 is what? 30 times U1. What's U1? U1 is what? The first velocity is 10. M2 is what?
According to the question, we have with a mass of 10 kg moving with velocity of 20 over 30 plus 10. When you multiply this number, 300 plus 200 over 40, which is what? 500 over 40. Cancel, cancel. So we have 50 over 4. 2 here, 25. 2 here, 2. Divide. We have 12.5 meter per second. That is the what? Common velocity of this question. Now let's take another question down. Question number 2. A body, okay, let's use an arrow of mass 5 kg is short. Okay, moving with a velocity of 100 meter per second. It shoots into a wooden block of mass 50 kg initial at rest. Calculate their common velocity after the impact. Now, look at this question very well. An arrow of mass 5 kg moving with a velocity of 100 meter per second is shot into a wooden block of mass 50 kg at rest. Calculate their common velocity after the impact. This question is case 3. Why? Because the arrow is moving while the block is stationary. So we are going to use this formula. V is equal to what? M1U1 over what? M1 plus M2. So V is equal to what? M1 in question, that is only the what? Mass of arrow. Then velocity of arrow, 100. Mass of arrow again, plus mass of the other one, which is wooden block, 50. That was 500 over 55. So 5 here, 100. 5 here, 11. Now, 11 divided by what? 100 divided by 11 is what? 9.98 meter per second. That is the second example. And this example is under case 3. It's under case 3. Why this one is under case 1? So you must know how to use the equation very well. Let's take one more example before we round up the class. Now, take for example an object of mass 20 kg moves with a velocity of 10 meter per second at 5 seconds. Calculate the force on the body. In this case, we are going to use this formula. F is equal to what? Mv over T. We assume the body is starting from rest. That is, U is out of it, change the momentum. So the force is equal to what? What is the mass in the question is what? 20 kg multiplied by what? The time at the velocity is what? 10. Why the time in the question is what? 5. Why are we using this formula? This formula can be used when the object is assumed to start from rest, whereby U is equal to what? 0. So from this formula, Ft is equal to what? Mv minus Mu. So in this one and this one is 0, which means Ft is equal to what? Mv. So can be used to apply to solve this question. So F is equal to what? When you multiply 20 times 10, the answer is what? 200 over what? 5. Now divide both sides by what? 5. If you divide it by 5, right? You have what now? 5 here 1, 5 here, 4, 5 is 0, 0. So the F is what? 40 Newton. So the force on the object that moves of mass is what? 40 Newton. So these are the things you need to know. Don't forget, there are three cases under collision or momentum. So we have the case 1, case 2, case 3. The questions are we dealt with. You can also solve more questions under the cases. Then, don't forget the Newton's law of motion. Don't forget the Newton, the first law, the second law, and the third law. Application of third law, we have recoil of a gun, jet and rocket repulsion, lift and elevator. They are application of the third law. So these are the things you need to know very well. They are very sensitive. So the questions are also very, they are very sensitive questions. You need to know how to solve them very well. Use the formula to GCSP so that you can arrive at your answer correctly. So that is that about Newton's third law and Newton's law of motion and collision. Thank you.